Guys, this is a real quick truck stop quickie, just so at least Chad can see his mufflers, and I know you guys don't want to watch another 30-minute muffler painting video, but let me just show you what I was able to do here. I probably couldn't get it quite as clean as mine, but I was just realizing before I was trying to run them bare and they had to be perfect. Now I'm going to be painting them, they didn't have to be quite so perfect. So, I mean, obviously some of the easy sides come out nice, but you always have this, probably this backside that's always getting the abuse. Let me get close so you can see what I'm talking about. And you can't, I just scrubbed with so many types of metal polish, and you just really can't get all of that off. I just scrubbed for so long with all different stuff, and it bumps, and you can feel it, it's bumpy. So that looked pretty good. The front is pretty dang good for a paint job. The back is a little bit worse than the ones I had where I couldn't quite get any cleaner than that, but then again, I don't think I'm going to paint the back. And this is very scrubbed with all kinds of polishes, acetones, and then alcohol on top. So that's the absolute cleanest I could get it. But when you compare, let's get the light going. When you compare side by side at the other one, it's pretty nice, pretty dang nice. So pretty much like the other one, that's about as clean as I got them. So I'm gonna do some light paint. It's not a good temperature for paints at all right now, but flats will be all right because they dry so quick and stuff. Just a few light coats to let it start setting up. And I'm not gonna do the whole muffler this time. That's a waste of paint, I realized. I think hers is an entire paint, yeah. Her Forester mufflers, the chopped ones, are fully painted, and I realized I wasted way too much paint on that job, like 6 or 8 cans, and there's no reason to paint the front half because you can't ever see it. So I'm gonna save a little paint, save a little money, and just do the normal full frontal nudity, and I'm gonna go like a little dusting toward the back like I used to do on some of the other ones. So I just wanted to show you at least one of them so it's documented. And then I'm gonna start polishing and cleaning this one after I hang this one up to dry. All right, I'm gonna take a peek under the rear seat bottoms to see what kind of matting we might be able to do there. That's the second to last step. Thanks to Brian Gable, I learned how to take out the rear seat without breaking it. Brian Gable is the one that had the WRX for a while, then he got the Golf R, then he totaled it. It's in a recent video, so if you haven't heard about that, interesting video. But thanks to Brian, he's made some good tutorials, kind of probably before I even did any of this. So I'll just show you the rear seat real quick. So just like he said, you reach in the middle, you find this little, two little bars, and you pull, and then you pull up. You pull and then pull up, and here's what it is. You reach under there, you find these somehow, and you go like that, and it pops the seat out of the hinges there. All right, now we'll see. Get the seat belts, of course, hold it off. That's a lot easier than I thought, guys. Woo. Ooh, that looks like a beaut right there. Super easy to mat. I'm definitely getting into that. I'll get that one done today. That's probably the easiest of all. Man, this poor seat with those car seats. I gotta get the mats back on the seat. We haven't been using the mats back when I was lifting. I gotta get those back on. And I can't wait to show my daughter that we found all her magnets. How the hell did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 magnets get under the seat? What a trip. Good, good, good. All right, I'm gonna, ooh, that's another magnet piece from their stuff. So, nothing else here, no more trash. Let's see, I might do a little, yeah, this should be very easy to mat compared to everything I've done so far. Very easy. So I'm actually looking forward to this one, unlike the other ones. All right, guys, I'm not going to disassemble much, but I do want to disassemble this just to get the edge here. So all I do is you're just going to pull up fast so it doesn't break. Then usually this won't pull out right, and you slide it, and then you got to get that clip out later for right there. So that's all you do to get those out. Both the clips stayed, so we got to take those out and put those back in the appropriate spots. Where do they go? Three of them. One, two. Be careful with this. Probably cut myself with these things. Let's see right there. These things are sharp. I should probably, I'm gonna stop, be smart, get gloves so I don't break it and slip my hand open. I had another, there it is, a tool here, just a little fork tool, pop out these, this little baby. I twist side to side. Perfect, right there. Here's gonna be my first piece. I guess I'll do a, looks like pretty similar on the other side. I'll do a mirror piece over there and then just fine tune it. But this is my piece for this side here. No cardboard template, I just kind of hand did it and avoided some of the more hassle bolts. Yeah? In a bit. Ooh, that looks like a goldfish, doesn't it?
It does.
Careful, it's sharp. Yeah. Yeah, no, I'll come in a bit.
Okay.
And we'll get all cleaned up. I want to finish getting dirty first, all right?
Okay.
All right. All right. So, let's see. You always draw on the back just for the hell of it. And what you gotta remember here, you want the silver the opposite direction of the shape. So I wouldn't do this, because this would be another piece and it wouldn't be a mirror. Like this. Trace it. And this will, as I said, this will need a little fine tuning. It's not exactly the same size, the same wires and harnesses on the other side, but it'll be a good start. And I could trim it a little more if I need to. But this will save a bunch of half the trimming. All right, let's see, is that right? Yeah, that's gonna be my mirror for the other side. All right, so you start at the edge and see, you work your way inward, because you're gonna have a lot of valleys, and if you stick at everything, you're not gonna get it to stretch into the valleys. So sort of like vinyl, see, you work it from left to right. This is going to be really bunched up and hard right here. I may trim a little bit here. Sort of like that. If you really want to get it to sit flat, you have to take out some of it on the really, really deep bends. So I'm going to roll these later. I'm just going to continue across, see what I got. Let's put down another piece. Okay. No real reason that there's no real point to keeping this wire free, because you still got your bolts covered. But what the hell, I just like to, in case some whatever diagnosis or pull out this thing or whatever. But I know you can't do much without the bolts anyway. There's a tiny, very, very small chance that it's ever going to need to be accessed. Plus, someone just takes it off simply if they need to access it. All right, where's my camera? There we go. I got it all done. I haven't rolled it yet. So it's always hard with the sun on this thing. There you go, I'll block the sun all the way across. A couple minis back in the back, folding down in the front, mostly kind of over the edge. Just really 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 big pieces is really all it needed, and then a couple patches here and there. I'm gonna roll all this out, which is the most satisfying part. All right, I'll show you the rolled stuff, even though it's not that fun. It took like literally 20 minutes just to roll it. It kind of sucks that it takes so long, but yeah, it came out all right. Sometimes they split when you're going into deep rivers and stuff, but overall, nice little job. Decent, pretty good coverage for a rear seat. Should quiet things down even more.